In the following video, we will demonstrate how to eFile and eServe and show you some of the features of our EFS tool. This is intended as an overview. Links to additional training will be available at the end of this demonstration. E-filing and e-serving is fast and it's easy. Let's take a look. A firm administrator will set up your account. Once set up, you'll log in using your email address and the password you've been given. This is the screen that you'll see upon logging in. It will display your filings with the most current filing at the top. If you want to file into a case, select this folder or click here to file a new case. From this page, you can also view the service contacts. Click here to see if anyone is available for service. If an email address is displayed here, it means they are available. Let's look at how to file into a case. Click the folder icon. This is the Parties tab. Notice the breadcrumbs across the top. These list the steps for filing and will be highlighted depending upon where you are in the process. Add additional parties if needed and continue to the next tab. To construct the filing, first, enter the filing code. Type the first few letters of the document type in the field to narrow the options in the list. And select the document code. We're also going to eServe into this case. To do so, check the service box. Notice that a new breadcrumb has been added along the top for service contacts. Next, enter the filing description. If you don't have a description to add, just copy the filing code. Enter the reference number. This is generally used for internal purposes. Next, select the appropriate fee for your filing and click Add. Upload the document. And select the appropriate security level. If you wish, you can add a filing comment here. This comment is just for your communication with the clerk. It is not saved in the court's computer system. You may also add a courtesy copy. Insert the email address of whomever you wish to receive a copy. They'll receive email notification with a link once the clerk accepts the document. Next, select the payment account, the party responsible for the fees, and if needed, choose the filing attorney. This field is optional. Now we'll determine our service contacts. Select or deselect contacts as needed, and proceed to the Summary tab. Take a moment to verify the information. If there are any errors, click the Edit button to make changes where needed. If all looks okay, click Submit. Check the box and agree to the terms to submit your filing. You may view your receipt or click OK to return to the Filings page. Here you can see that your filing is being submitted. The status will change to indicate when the filing is processing, when it's under review, that is, being looked at by the court, and when it has been accepted by the court. That's it! You've filed your case. No trips to the courthouse, no FedEx pickup, just a few minutes at the computer. For more information on e-filing and e-serving, or to attend a training, click the links below.